Israelson here. I'm just coming on because I want to share some stuff with you guys. But we just had Tom Scarella, an evangelist from St. Paul, Minnesota, come and minister at our church. And he shared a prophetic word with us that was pretty powerful, spoke right into my heart, and just really encouraged me to be free to share my journey and to share some of the encounters and different things that I've had with the Holy Spirit with the rest of the world. And so I'm just really excited to do this, and I'm gonna probably be doing a few videos that will share some of my story, some of my journey. And so please tune in and come back on the channel, and you can find me on my page, Stephanie Israelson. Please like and subscribe and my videos. And but anyways, I just want to start out, probably I want to go back to just some of my early childhood and just share some encounters that I had with the Lord back then. So when I think back to my very first encounter that I ever had with the Holy Spirit, I was pretty young. And you know, God always put dreams, gave me dreams as a little girl as well. I would pretty much always sing myself to sleep. I would be singing music, singing songs, and pretending that I was like Candy Hempel as I was laying in my bed, and Candy Hempel was my favorite at the time, and that was pretty cool. But I would sing myself to sleep, and then I would go into these dreams. I would have dreams, I believe they were from the Lord. I'd have dreams that I would be on a stage, and I'd have this same dream all the time, that I'd be on a big stage and I'd be looking out and there'd be people as far as the eye could see, and I'd be singing and prophesying and preaching and all this crazy stuff. So God just started depositing and nurturing this dream in my heart as a young girl to be a singer and to be a powerful woman of God. So that's kind of a little bit of that earlier on. And then when I was about 9 years old, I had a crazy encounter with God at our church, at our home church. My dad was a fiery evangelist. We traveled all over Canada and parts of the United States. But we were back home at this time. And the evangelist that was visiting our church, his name was Harold Chamberlain. We called him Uncle Harry because my dad, in the earlier days, we would go, dad would tour with Uncle Harry and play the organ. My dad's an incredible organ player as well. So he was visiting our home church and we were all there, and it was near the end of the service and I was kind of at the back, and I remember standing back there with a couple of friends, and Uncle Harry was on the stage. There was probably half the people were gone already, and it was really cool because he's standing up there, he still had the mic in his hand, and he said like it was just a moment, okay? He's like, whoa, the presence of God is gonna come in this place, wait for it. And all of a sudden, I looked around and people all over the building started dropping like flies under the presence of God. The power of God came in the room so strong. And so that was really cool. I looked to my left and there was one of my uncles and his wife and their kids, and they were holding babies in their arms, and literally they went out under the power of God. They were slain out. The next thing I know, I begin to feel something coming on me, and the next thing I know, I open my eyes, like I'm just in my belly and I'm just feeling like I started crying and just feeling all warm and fuzzy inside. And next thing I know, I open my eyes, I'm on the floor, and I look up and there's my friends standing there looking at me. And I was like, whoa, like what happened? I'm crying and I just feeling the emotion and my love for God. So I stood back up, and next thing I know, I open my eyes and I'm on the floor again. And so I'm looking up and my friends are standing over me, so I get back up. Well, this happens to me 3 times that night. The power of God was so strong on me. And so this is my first encounter with just experiencing the presence of God and being so overwhelmed. And so anyways, the last time I get up, all of a sudden this woman comes and grabs me by the arm. I don't know who it was, actually, to this day. I can't remember, but anyway, she took my arm and took me up to the front of the church, and there in like the second pew back, my sister was sitting there and a friend or two of hers, and the lady directs me to sit beside my sister. And someone laid their hands on my head, and when they did that, I was filled with the Spirit, and I began to speak in other tongues. Here I am, a 9-year-old child, approximately. I was pretty sure I was 9. I began to speak in tongues, and I look at my sister. She's speaking in tongues, and the other girl that was sitting there. We were all speaking in tongues, and I look up. I'm crying, and Uncle Harry, he comes down. He's kind of standing there in front of me, and he walks by, and he's like, yeah, and he winks, and it was just so cool. So that was my first encounter with the Holy Spirit as a child, and so experiencing this as a young girl and having dreams from, I know they're from God at that point. It began to nurture a hunger in me for the supernatural. It began to nurture a desire to experience God more. And so the second experience that I had that was kind of similar, I mean, we were always, because my dad was an evangelist, my sister and I were always in meetings and always attending anointed services. So I was very accustomed to being in that atmosphere. And so about a year later from that incident, when that happened, there was an evangelist that was traveling through the area. Actually, we had to drive quite a few hours for this one. And it was 1988. We drove from Heartland, New Brunswick to Newcastle. And I believe that's in Nova Scotia, Newcastle, Nova Scotia. Maybe it's in New Brunswick, I don't know. But anyways, the city was called Newcastle, and Benny Hinn was gonna be there. And back in those days, there wasn't much known about Benny Hinn. But we heard that God was doing some crazy things in his ministry. So my parents were hungry. We drove down to Newcastle. We get in this service. He was there a couple of nights, and I believe it was on the last night that we were there. It was the end of the service. He preached, and it's cool because I had gone to the children's ministry, and I didn't really like it, so I came back down to the main service, and I was there for this. I was so glad that I was, but anyways, at the end of the service, he said, the presence of God is gonna come into this place. Are you hungry? Do you want a touch from God? And so my parents grabbed my sister and I, and we went out of the aisle and tried to make our way down front. Well, this place was packed. It was just a huge, like, gymnasium type room from what I can remember. And it seemed like everybody in that building was hungry. Everybody was thirsty for more of God. So when we went out into the aisle, it was like shoulder to shoulder. And being a kid, man, I couldn't see. We were just packed in there like sardines in a can. So we get out, and everyone's just kind of pushing as close to the front as we could. And I could see through the people. I could see Benny Hinn. And all of a sudden, he waved his arm across the people, and he went shoo when he did that. And when he did that, you could see, like, from the front to the back, people just began to fall and under the power of God. And so when this came to, when people began to fall and it came to us where we were standing, all of a sudden from my toes, just right up my body, very slowly, it just kind of zoomed up my body, this electric current. And I looked around, and it was really cool because it was just a paralyzing electric current that went through our bodies, and we all went down. But the funny thing is, because we were so packed in this this big room, people were on top of each other. It was crazy. But the presence of God came, and man, I encountered something so real, and I knew that as a young child, this God is so real, and it cultivated that hunger. I just wanted more and more. So as a young child, I felt a closeness with the Holy Spirit as well. And my sister would always say to me that, oh, you were preaching in your dreams again, or you were rebuking the devil again in your dreams. And I remember I would wake up and I'd be sitting up in bed and I'd be preaching to the masses in my dreams, and just, you know, the different encounters and things that I've had. I want to be able to share those, and I feel like for a long time I've kind of been bound up and I haven't wanted to share these things, but after these services we had here this past week with Brother Tom, I know that God's calling me to just release this story that's in my heart. I want to release it for my kids so that they can have it for years to come. And if anyone online gets to see, out there in the internet world, gets to see my video, I just think that'll be really cool. So watch out for some more videos that we'll be releasing, and I want to share more on some different encounters that I've had with the Holy Spirit. Anyways, stay tuned and like this video, subscribe to my channel, check out this link here, and check out our website. God bless you guys, and I'm just praying that you, if you watch this video, that you are going to have encounters with the Holy Spirit as well. God bless, guys. Thanks for watching.